On the watch walking up here, my path has just gotten smaller. I love this reading. Actually, as I prepared for this sermon, I remembered it jogged my memory and brought back some history for me. The very first congregation I ever served was in northwestern Ohio, and my first sermon to that call committee was on Mark chapter 12, verses 38 through 44. I remember it quite plainly because I got up in front of them and I recanted what the text said, right? At the very beginning of it, it says, Jesus says, beware of men wearing long flowing robes who sit in places of honor. Right? Beware of men who wear long flowing robes who seek out the best seats because what? They devour widows' houses. And then he goes on to give us the text of, he sat down across from the treasury and watched people put money into the box. It's kind of like Bill's Jesus, and this is the box. Only as an analogy here, Bill. I'm not, you know. You just sat in the right place this morning for me. So he's sitting, he's watching, and people are putting in money, right? And along comes this widow who puts in two small copper coins, which amount to what we now would think of as a penny. Imagine if you had just a penny to live on, first of all. Think about that for a moment. And think about where these boxes are going, where people probably have less than a penny to live on. Jesus saw this woman put in, and he said to his disciples, he called his disciples to him, and he says, look, this widow has put in everything she has to live on. Her gift is much greater than these others who have put in out of their abundance, but truly she has given her whole life. And when you've heard that and when you've been taught about this passage before, how have you heard it? As Jesus holding this woman up as a wonderful example of faith and stewardship? Or that the system is keeping her in a place that she doesn't need to be? How have you heard it? Right? And this morning it's the perfect example of the way that we've always heard it, right? Because what are we doing this morning, right? You all have your little yellow cards that you're getting ready to turn in to tell us what it is that you're going to give to the church next year, because it's all about sacrificial giving and giving beyond our means and everything that we have, right? Jesus is holding this woman up as a model giver and the perfect steward of all of her gifts. Yes, this is yes, this is no. How have you heard it? Is that what you've heard before? That she's the model steward and this is how all of us should live. Is there any kind of inflection in there to say that that's what Jesus actually said? Let's look at this again. Jesus said, the disciples said, and truly I tell you this, poor widow has put in more than all of those who are contributing to the treasury. For all of them have contributed out of their abundance, but she has, out of her poverty, has put in everything she has, all she has to live on. Does Jesus actually commend her? When he wants you to do something, what does he usually say? He holds up the value of what that person has done, and then he says, go and do likewise. Does he say that? What did he just say before this? Beware of men in long flowing robes. And who are those men in long flowing robes? They are the Pharisees and the scribes. And not all scribes are bad. If you read up a little bit further in Mark, first up, meaning back in chapter 12, there's a spot in there about a scribe who talked about the greatest commandments, right? Love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Right? There's a scribe that talks about that and how other scribes don't do that. But Jesus says, beware of the scribes, because out of the system that they've set up, what do? They devour widows' houses. And Jesus literally says of this poor widow who puts these two copper coins into the pot, he says, everything, all she had to live on. Actually, what he says there in the Greek is she put in her whole life. The word is bion, which is comes bio. And those of you who are taking biology, bio is
life.
She put in her entire life into that pill. Why? Maybe because God moved her. Maybe because the system of the temple is such that it had to be She had to do it to be a part of what was going on there. Because the verses right after this, Jesus leaves the temple for the very last time, Mark chapter 13, verse 1, because in Mark chapter 11 is where he entered Jerusalem in the triumphal entry. We are now into Holy Week. This is happening during Holy Week. And he's in the temple, he sees this woman does this, he leaves the temple for the last time, and he says, "Truly I tell you, not one of these stones will be on top of another." He predicts the destruction of the temple. And is that the destruction of the physical temple, or is that the destruction of the system that has been set up? Because we're not here to promote and perpetuate a religious system, which is what this is. Council's probably cringing right now. Right? It's not about setting up and perpetuating a religious system. It's about setting up and perpetuating the fact that God loves each and every one of us and has given us everything. And yes, this story this morning is about two widows. Two widows that give everything. Elijah says, "Don't worry, it's not going to run out." And this other widow puts all of her life into the treasury. And God takes care of them. Interesting question I saw as I was preparing for this sermon. One pastor asked on a website that does text study stuff, he asked, "So if Jesus is actually not commending this widow, what then happened to her? If she put all of her money into the treasury, what happened? Did she go home and die?" You know what? I don't have an answer for that. Because the Bible doesn't tell us. What I can tell you is that we're supposed to look out for those people. Right? Who would have seen this widow if Jesus had not been sitting there? Would the men in the long flowing robes have noticed the gift that she put in? Would the disciples have noticed if Jesus had brought it up? Would we have noticed? We sit in this room each and every Sunday morning. Most of us in the same spot, I don't know when you're not here. And we sit next to most of the same people, week in and week out, and we see them. But do you see them? Do you know what they're going through? Do you know what the struggles are in their lives? Do you know who doesn't like their job and is trying to find another one? Do you know who just lost their job and can't find another one? Do you know who's dealing with a sick parent or a sick child? Do we know what's happening in the lives of those around us? We see them. Do we actually see them? That's what Jesus is trying to get us to see here this morning in this widow. Yes, she gave everything she had, and yes, that's a wonderful gift that she gave because God allowed her to do that. Or maybe the religious system is keeping her captive and poor in a way that she's not supposed to be. And that's that the religious system is supposed to raise the poor and alleviate the stresses of life. I see it going both ways. But I think what really needs to be seen here is the fact that Jesus wants us to not just look at that person that next to us in the pew and know them by name. But we should know them enough that we can pray for their needs and help them in their times of struggles. And if we know them that way, then they're going to know us that way. And they're going to be able to help us. Because this form is the reality of life. We live in a religious system that we have to perpetuate, even though we're not supposed to do that. But the one thing about this form that is wonderful, that helps us even in our times of need, because you know what? I know there's people here that can give beyond what they're giving now. And there are people here that are giving beyond what they can give now. And what I want each and every one of us to do is to look right here, and then also in that checkbook. I should have had my checkbook here this morning so I could have that. Look right here in that book and figure out what it is we can give. And if you can't give anything right now, I don't want you to. I don't think the council wants you to either. And I don't think any of the other members of this congregation would want you to do that either. There's a box on here that says, pray, right? It's still on there. If you can't give money, give your prayers. Because I tell you what, prayers work.
I can give you many, and I'm sure people here can give you many examples of that.
Because it's not about the money. Because there's no congregation that is in dire need of money. There's no congregation that actually has a financial problem. The problem is getting the money from this pocket to that plate. We have every last dime that we need to do all of the ministry that God is calling us to, and I 100% believe that. And this card is going to help us figure out what we can do to a point. But we also have to rely on God, and that's what the widows did this morning. And if we can see each other, then we're going to know where we're at. And we're going to be able to talk about where God is leading us to, because that is what it's really all about. It's about seeing everything around us and everyone around us in need, and being able to be who God has called us to be each day, each hour, each minute. So look at yourselves, and then actually look at those around you. And let us see as God sees.